Let's talk about similar matrices. So first, a definition. Two matrices A and B, suppose they're square matrices. A is said to be similar to B if there's an invertible matrix P that has the property that A is equal to P times B times P inverse. So some things to notice here in the definition. We're only defining this property to talk about square matrices. Both have to be n by n, same size. And the definition is an existent statement. And so two matrices are similar if there exists this invertible matrix P that has a certain property. This matrix P, if it exists, is also going to be the same size as the matrices A and B. And notice if A is similar to B, so that A is P times B times P inverse, then we can solve for B and see that B is P inverse times A times P. What that means is we can write B as QA Q inverse, where Q is just P inverse. In other words, if A is similar to B, then B is similar to A. So the similarity property is symmetric. So next is a theorem that talks about similar matrices and its relationship to eigenvalues. So two n by n matrices A and B, if they're similar, then they have the same characteristic polynomial. And that tells us that they're going to both have the same eigenvalues with the same multiplicities. So here's a quick proof. We just need to show that the characteristic polynomial of each one the characteristic polynomial of A is equal to the characteristic polynomial of B whenever A and B are similar. And so we're just going to compute using the fact that A is similar to B and properties of the determinant. So if A is similar to B, then there's this invertible matrix P so that A is P times B times P inverse. And then A minus lambda I, we can write it as PB P inverse minus lambda I. And the identity matrix is just P times P inverse. And so we can write this as PB P inverse minus lambda P P inverse. And now we can factor out P from the right and from the left and get that this is P times the quantity B minus lambda I times P inverse. And then we just take determinant. So the determinant of A minus lambda I, this is the characteristic polynomial for A. This is equal to the determinant of P times the quantity B minus lambda I times P inverse. And now we're going to use the multiplicative property of determinant. So that's determinant P times the characteristic polynomial of B times determinant P inverse. And determinant P inverse, remember, is just 1 over determinant P. And so those are scalars that cancel, and therefore determinant A minus lambda I is determinant B minus lambda I. So this shows that the characteristic polynomials are the same. So here's a warning, though. So similarity is not the same as row equivalence. When you do row operations, usually you're going to change the eigenvalues of a matrix. The second warning is similarity implies that matrices have the same eigenvalues, but having the same eigenvalues does not imply the matrices are similar. So for example, this matrix 5, 3, 0, 5 has the same eigenvalue as 5, 0, 0, 5, but the matrices are not similar. Later, what we're going to see is similar matrices represent the same linear transformation, but just in terms of a different basis, so a different choice of coordinate system. This will end up being very useful when we start changing coordinates in order to study systems of linear equations, and we're going to find coordinates that are suitably adapted to solving the problems we're interested in.